Scientists at Johns Hopkins have recently described a remarkable success in the treatment of patients with a particular kind of cancer, cancers with a defect in mismatch repair. Now, to understand the basis for this remarkable success, it's very important to go through the history of research. DNA is made up of four chemicals, abbreviated A, C, T, and G, which are arranged in two chains. Our cells are able to synthesize copies of these two chains every time they divide. But sometimes there are errors made during this copying process, leading to mismatches between the two chains. Cells can correct these mismatches using a system called mismatch repair. In a perfect situation, the mutations are eliminated and the cells continue their normal growth. But what if a cell contains a defect in mismatch repair and the mutation goes unnoticed? This leads to the development of abnormal proteins made from the mutated DNA. These abnormal proteins are often present in cancer cells, particularly those which are defective in mismatch repair. The body is not helpless, though, against this situation. The immune system has a process called a checkpoint which can seek out and destroy cells containing such abnormal proteins. Unfortunately, cancer cells can sometimes sneak through this checkpoint process. Recently, scientists have developed a way to inhibit these immune checkpoints, strengthening the body's ability to detect and eliminate cancer cells. Immune checkpoint inhibitors represent a major breakthrough in the fight against many cancers, but are particularly effective against cancers with mismatch repair deficiency.
So what we found is that we could use a marker in tissue across any tumor type that would identify a patient to respond to this PD-1 inhibition. And so we were able to use this marker to find patients that could really benefit. So these patients had response, and these responses were durable. We have patients who are on treatment for over 2 years, which stopped, and now 3 years out are still disease-free. So that's very exciting. However, to move forward, we really need to bring this to patients. So the very important first next step is to find these patients and to do the testing to identify the patients so we can bring this therapy to them.